this unit, we are going to examine how error propagates when we compute a dot product. And let's start with a very simple example where the vectors only have two elements each. And we're going to only deal with real valued vectors. So instead of having X Hermitian transpose times Y, we're going to have X transpose Y. And obviously, if we write that out, we get this expression right here. And we're going to say that it's that the result is stored in kappa. Now, we know that when we do this on a computer, we are not going to get kappa exactly. We're going to get kappa check. And that is going to be the result of performing floating point computation when we compute our dot product. And the notation for that is this, given by these square brackets. Now recall that every time you do a sub operation, you're going to incur floating point error. So what we really need to do is say, well, this sub operation is going to be computed and then stored, and therefore we end up with an error, and the same thing for this sub operation, and then finally we end up with a final operation, the addition here, which then incurs yet another error. Now we can apply the standard computational model to work out what kind of errors actually occur. So we do this first multiplication, and that gives us chi 0 psi 0 times sum 1 plus epsilon. We do this computation, we get a chi 1 times psi 1 times 1 plus epsilon. And then we do our addition, and we get one final 1 plus epsilon. Now, these aren't all the same epsilon. In particular, these come from multiplications, and this one comes from an addition. And then still, this one is not the same as that, so maybe we should put a superscript on it to indicate where those came from. And since we're going to extend this to vectors with more than two elements, we'll actually end up with more of these epsilons as well. So we're going to put a superscript on here as well. And notice that all of these epsilons in magnitude are bounded by the machine epsilon. Now, at this point, you can distribute this error term so that we actually separate it into the different terms of the addition. So what we get then is chi 0 psi 0 times 1 plus epsilon star 0 times 1 plus epsilon plus 1 plus chi 1 psi 1 times 1 plus epsilon star 1 times 1 plus epsilon plus 1. And all of that can be what we believe is quite elegantly stated as chi 0 chi 1 transpose times a diagonal matrix times psi 0 psi 1, and in that diagonal matrix we get 1 plus epsilon star 0 times 1 plus epsilon plus 1, and then 1 plus epsilon star 1 times 1 plus epsilon plus 1, and then zeros out here. And if you multiply that out, you get exactly this expression right here. And this is kind of a nice general expression, because we can now associate the error with X, or we can associate it with Y, or we can split it. And there are lots of different ways in which to throw the error back at the input. So we're now going to let you do the same exercise, but with vectors with three elements each. And then in the next unit, we'll reconvene. And we'll look at the very general solution. And what you're going to find out is that this is relatively straightforward, But notation just kind of gets in the way. So we're going to introduce some new notation to make everything cleaner.